Welcome back to part 3 of our epic Botswana adventure. You join us at Nata Bird Sanctuary as we pack up camp.
So last night at Nata Bird Sanctuary, we met up with Bruce from Overlanding with Bruce. And we've decided he's going to take us on a few cut lines for the next couple of days. Tonight he's going to take us to the cut line on Kakunya Island. And then tomorrow we're going to head to the CKGR cut line. I'm super excited. This is going to be awesome. What an adventure this is going to be.
We're right here at Nata Bird Sanctuary. So we're going to go down the main road here. Mm-hmm. We're going to hit this cut line, the first cut line. We're all the way down there.
Okay.
And then across to Kakunya Island. And then from there, we'll go hit the cut line all the way down.
Yes.
And here's Central Kalahari.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we'll go to and then we'll come down here. But you don't want to do this 100 k's again.
No.
So it's badly corrugated.
Yeah, it's horrible.
So all we do is we carry on straight.
All right.
We might end up camping over here.
Yes.
Off the main track, because a lot of farmers use, well, not a lot. One in 3 days, you know, one every 2 days uses.
Okay.
So we might come down here, camp around here, then back.
Okay.
And then come down. And then it's top.
With camp all packed up, it was time to hit the road. We had a short drive on the tarmac before we turned off onto the dirt roads for the excitement to begin. This is the type of adventure that we like to do. Thick, dense bush, middle of nowhere, no people, no cars, anywhere in sight. This is why we do the cut lines. This is the adventure that we need.
It's 10 o'clock in the morning and it's like 33 degrees.
Yeah, it's scorching.
It's winter.
They call it winter. We just call it another day in the bush.
Definitely the hardest day.
Driving the Discovery was Bruce's brother Heath. We're here on the cut lines now. Absolutely loving it. What an adventure Bruce is bringing us on. But the temperature is slowly rising, so it's definitely time to crack a cold one and carry on.
birds.
Yeah.
How awesome is this? That's from Queen Island.
Oh, okay.
About 15 k's.
Yeah?
Doesn't look like it, eh?
Not at all.
So, cats on back with a ton of food.
That's a lot of awesome home, isn't it?
Hey, amazing, eh?
Yes.
That's what I don't understand why people don't do more.
Oh, yeah.
It's not advertised. People don't know that.
Yep. Awesome. So what's the plan for now? Go down and...
It's about 2 k's
there.
Right. Hopefully the fans are dry. I'm sure they are. As long as out in the middle, it sometimes gets a bit wet.
All right. So just from here to there?
Yeah. It's probably awesome. About 12 k's.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Cool. All
right. Where is he?
What a place! Sour Pan. That's where we're going to us. Kukunya Island. I think we're going to be the only ones there. This is going to be awesome. See the landies. How cool is that? Start for tonight.
If you like it, we camp here.
It's hard not to like it, eh?
What do you think of this for a campsite?
Yes.
Underneath this massive, beautiful baobab tree, overlooking this endless sea of salt. It's absolutely gorgeous. I think we're gonna have something cold, and then we're gonna take a drive up to the viewpoint. Just admire this beautiful place that we are.
After a cold one and relaxing around camp for the afternoon, we decided to go for a drive around the island. A massive thanks to Bruce for these epic drone shots.
Doing a little trip around the island. Check at the size of this baobab. Holy cow! This thing must be 10,000 years old. Look at it!
monster. There's another big one over there. Holy moly. What a day of adventure in the middle of Botswana. We find ourselves at this amazing campsite underneath this massive baobab tree. The sun is just about to set. It's a bit murky, so the sunset is going to be next level. It's actually going to be properly lekker. So right now, I think we're going to have a start a fire, put the meat on the braai, pour a nice cold gin, and watch that sun go down. This is awesome. Absolutely epic. Thank you to Bruce for bringing us to this magic spot. Kakunya, in my opinion, better than Kubu. So if you can make the plan to do one of them, come here. Absolutely. This is amazing.
They make wiring, they use a oil that's like a fish oil or something. That's what affects them.
After an absolutely beautiful sunset, we had dinner and we just relaxed around the fire. Good morning. It's an absolutely beautiful morning here on Kakunya Island. Waking up, sleeping underneath this baobab is just such a unique, special experience that you actually can't get anywhere else. This is why we do overlanding. You do not know where you're going to spend the night. You find the most incredible spots that no one ever camps at. This place. It's definitely going to be on the list for the next trip, that's for sure. Now for today, we're going to do about 300 kilometers of cut lines all the way down to the CKGR and the Kutsi Game Reserve. And then on those cut lines, that's where we're going to find our next camp for tonight. Yeah, I think it's going to be absolutely special. I think it's going to be an amazing trip all the way on the cut lines. Thick sand, lots of corrugations, hopefully lots of animals. But let's see where we end up tonight. With camp all packed up, it was time to hit the road. Please always remember, when camping like this in the middle of the bush, only leave the footprints and tire tracks. We'll be right back. We were having a fantastic morning enjoying the cutlines, but it was time to stop, have some breakfast and stretch some legs.
We've just got onto the CKGR cut line. This is going to be epic. What a day we've had already. The adventure, the road we've been on, it's been so much fun. Absolutely epic. Absolutely epic.
When driving on soft sand, it's always advised to lower your tire pressures. We forgot to do this in the first part of the cut line. And what a difference it makes.
Yeah. But I gotta say that road is probably the funnest, nerve-wracking and most adrenaline pumping road I've ever been on.
Like Amri says, she says, yeah, I hate sand. I said, why? She says, because you can get stuck. I said, if you get stuck,
you can get anywhere.
There's three of us, we can help each other.
That was epic.
That was so close because I think we were all sleeping.
Yes. Yeah. I enjoyed that a lot. Sure, that was cool.
Good drive. Well done.
Thank you. Yeah.
But let your tires down.
Yeah, exactly.
Let go. Oh, jeez, and I got my cap on backwards because I've been taking photographs. But let your tires down. Don't be lazy like Bruce.
Yeah. Jeez, like, what a difference. Thick sand, tires go right down.
Yeah.
No, I was cruising in some parts of fourth gear. Like 1,500.
Do you want to be depressed?
Yeah?
I had my cruise control at 45 k's an hour with having a couple of
Well, read between the lines, eh? Let's go find a campsite.
Yeah. So, let's just drive. You choose a campsite. It's up to you tonight.
Oh, my goodness.
It's up to you. Right, the pressure's all on you. So, you got to not be seen from a distance and.
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit sheltered because I think the wind's going to
Pump today.
Yeah.
All right.
Up to you.
Let's go see. Okay. CKGR cut line here. I've never been so relieved to switch off a car at a campsite in my life. It's been quite a day. It's time for something strong and a campfire and just relax for our last night in Bots. Yeah, tomorrow we head back to Joburg, unfortunately. But all good things must come to an end. And we'll see you guys. Well, we'll see you for the next adventure. Yep, our campsite for the night. Yep, open camping in the middle of the central Kalahari. Let's hope something comes tonight and make things a little interesting. The next morning, we're up early. We still had a long way to go before we could reach the border. With all this thick sand making going quite difficult, there was one small problem that was starting to edge its way into the room. Bruce, do you want to explain yourself?
Tyrone, you should never have told me not to get extra fuel. This is a real rookie mistake of mine.
Oh yeah.
Went against what I always preach. I didn't carry spare fuel just in case. With the thick sand and this trailer, I was double the fuel that I would normally. So thanks to Tyron for sponsoring my remaining part of my trip in the fuel. Thanks for the sponsorship, Tyron.
Yeah, I don't know if you're gonna make it even.
Oh, do I have
even
to
on that?
Do I have to give this fuel back?
Yeah, man. I saw a couple of. Rum at the back there.
Yeah. Yeah, Tyron, you saved me there.
Oh, okay, happy
I'm showing
to help,
everybody what not to do when you travel. Okay, so yeah. This is a lesson. I planned this.
Oh, I suck.
It's a planned exhibition of what not to do.
You've taught me so much this trip already. I appreciate this. That is 7 days of dirt roads, corrugations and thick sand. All comes down now, back on the top. Now we're going to try and get to a fuel station. It's going to be cutting it close. With a few extra jerry cans, we eventually made it to a fuel station. All filled up, we made a beeline to the border. I hope you enjoyed our epic Botswana adventure. I hope you guys liked and subscribed to the channel, and I can't wait to see you in the next adventure.